This is the old air compressor I bought for this new shop. It was a really good deal, and it's really big. It originally had a 20 horsepower motor, three phase. Don't have three phase power out this far in the country, so I'm having to convert to single phase. Got a 10 horse on there, see if that's going to pull it. I'm sure I won't be able to go up to 200 pounds like the original would, but for what I'll do, it should be adequate. It's a two stage, three cylinder. Give you an idea of just how large these cylinders are. This is a 16-ounce can. It's a pretty good size cylinder there. Pressure gauge on there. Let's go turn it on. I don't have any of the controls hooked up, so I just, for a test run, got it hooked pretty much straight wired. Like I said, the previous owner was selling this compressor really cheap. It does have some problems that have to be fixed. Originally, this air valve would activate the unloader and take the pressure off of the pumping cylinders while the electric motor was trying to start. And it does it with oil pressure. When the crankshaft in the compressor is not turning, the oil pump's not turning, and this valve lets air pressure get the unloaders. But something's wrong in there, so I'm going to use an electric solenoid valve here to control the unloader instead and just blank this off. And the unloader itself is a piston. The pilot control line goes in here. There's a piston in here that pushes down and holds the inlet valve open. So the compressor pump is turning, the piston in the cylinder is moving, but it's not building any pressure, so the flywheel turns freely. Once the electric motor RPM is up, then the pressure is released from here, this piston retracts, and the valves work normally, and you get pressure. And because it's a two-stage pump, the two larger cylinders take in the air and compress it to a certain degree, not sure exactly how much pressure, into this cooling coil here called the intercooler. And from there, it goes into the second stage high-pressure cylinder. And that completes the compression process. And this compressor pump is good for up to 200 psi. It would safely run continuously at 200 psi with a big enough motor. But I know there's no way this motor would do that. It would stall before that point. And in case there's an imbalance between the two stages, there's a pressure safety valve here. The first stage is trying to do too much of the work. That'll pop off to protect the pump itself and indicate that there's a problem. And if the unloader pistons all leak, when the pilot air pressure hits them, some of that air pressure goes into the to the compressor and not doesn't stay in there and activate. So we've got to fix that and get the electric pilot control hooked up. And I was also missing the air filters, so hooked that up. And hopefully get some good service out of this. I still think I need a larger motor. I think that one's going to be overtaxed. But pump itself shouldn't wear out anytime soon.